time for your starts of the best Blazer team in history.
Famer! By the end of the season, he was probably the best power forward in the league. And many credited him as being the difference maker in a great championship series. Being represented by his wife, Pam, the enforcer, number 20, Maurice Lewis. A rookie in 77, the fifth pick in the draft that year, and he, along with the rest of the reserves, never missed a beat when he was placed out on the floor. If you remember his nickname was the Who, Wally Walker.
Wally!
The rubber band man, backing up Bill Walton, was no easy task, but given the opportunity, if you remember, he often saved the day, number 34, Robin Jones. He scored 20 points in the second half alone. Rescue the team from defeat in game 2 of the Western Conference Finals against the Los Angeles Lakers. Catapulting them on to win the championship down the line. He's being represented tonight by his sons, Jay and Ricky, number 3, Herman Gilliam. And an ultimate team player, as most of these, in fact, all of these guys were team players, and doing whatever the coach asked of him, and oftentimes was shutting down the opposition's star. We love him very much. Number 10, Corky Calhoun. With his quickness and defensive pressure. He was also usually the recipient of Mr. Walton's long outlet passes and grabbed that rebound at the end of that series. Remember that? Number 16, Johnny Davis.
Johnny!
And inside, he was a monster. He comes to many of our games to this day, number 36, Lloyd Neal. A defensive savvy, enabled him to lead the league in steals that year. But he sure could score it just as well. He was all over that floor, number 15, Larry Steele. Do you remember?
Pinball.
Which was well deserved. When watching him twisting his way and riding to the hoop, lickety-brindle up the middle, if you were. And when he bounced off the defenders, but scored in the process. Number 13, David Schwarzer. The quietest guy ever to wear a Trailblazer jersey. I thought he talked a lot. He let his game do the talking, and boy, did he talk in the playoffs. Mm-hmm. Number 14, the train, Reinhardt. 77, he was dominating, averaging 18 points a game, leading the league in rebounds and blocks. his team was first, and that defined that group. Now that he can talk, we can't keep him quiet. He comes to the games quite often, and without him, it might not have been a championship year. Mr. Bobby Brooks. If you will, we have so many guys who have great stories to tell. We've had a wonderful time this past couple of days with all of us, but we have a second half of the game to play tonight. So to speak, on behalf of the team, Lionel Hollins. Lionel?
Play the organization for inviting us back and allowing us to have this opportunity to share a great moment in our life. I want to thank Paul Allen, Neil O'Shea, the general manager. It's been a special 2 or 3 days that we've been here, being able to reminisce and tell big fish stories about what happened. As you know, as we've gotten older, the games were better. We never made any mistakes. We scored more points than we thought we scored.
Youngest team. Nuggets team, baby!
With you, the fans, the greatest fans in the NBA, Rip City. Yeah.
Thank you, team. There was a team effort that won the championship back in 1977, and don't you forget it. So let's get the team together, all together. Maybe one more time for another team photo. Thank you very much.